Hey guys, welcome back to our bottle of popcorn. My name is Stephanie. Thank you all for clicking on this video. So March has come to an end. I'm a little bit late on this one, when it comes to these videos, but it is time to rank the 8 new 2021 March movies that I saw. I know I said 8 and there's 9 movies on here. I finally saw The Father this month, officially come out at the end of February, but it came out video on demand in March, so I saw it and I really want to talk about it, so that's why I have it fresh on my list. So it's an official March movie, but I'm gonna go ahead and like sneak it in here because they come out at the end of February. February is like a short month. Come out like February 26th. Yes, I'm gonna sneak it in here, you guys. It is what it is. Let's get on with it. So, The Father, it is the last Best Picture nominee that I needed to watch out of the 8 films. Do look out for a ranking of the 8 nominees. I was just waiting to watch this one. So it does star Anthony Hopkins and Olivia Colman. Both of them are nominated for an Oscar. And I'm just gonna say wow, you guys. It is definitely a tearjerker. Well, if you're like an emotional person when it comes to movies, make sure you have your tissues ready. I was not prepared. Thankfully, I saw it at home, but I was not prepared for the crying there at the end. I really didn't think I was gonna cry with this movie. But we are following Anthony, who is played by Anthony Hopkins, who unfortunately it does suffer from dementia. I feel like it's done so beautifully. Olivia Colman plays his daughter, who is struggling to balance her life with trying to, you know, of course, help her father. If this movie could just give you like a tiny, tiny little like tenth of a feeling of what these people go through, it's just absolutely heartbreaking. Just again, just the way that their mind works, the things that they feel they're seeing, the confusion. I don't think it's going to really win too many awards, unfortunately, but definitely a good Oscar contender in my opinion. May not be for everybody because it is more of a slow tone movie. It's not too much excitement going on. That ending, you guys, is just that right there alone is why he got nominated for an Oscar. We're gonna go on with the actual March movies. First up would be Boss Level, which you can find on Hulu, I believe it is. I know a lot of people are comparing it to Groundhog's Day, which is like the one that you compare a movie when we are repeating the same day over and over. I personally, just because of all the violence and the killing and stuff, would compare it more to like Happy Death Day. So it is a sci-fi action and it stars Frank Grillo. Yeah, I know I suck with names. We also have Mel Gibson. We also have Naomi Watts. So it has a really, really good cast. It is action-packed. It knows the type of movie that it is. It's not like this great, wonderful movie. So I won't really go into... Well, I do normally give spoilers on this particular video. No, not... I think I do. Like, minimal spoilers? I think so. Well, anyways, we're gonna do that now if we didn't do it before. So again, we're repeating the same day. It's pretty much... He goes like a year, I think it is, repeating the same exact day, just kind of getting to, you know, figure out how it is to be surviving, and then kind of having this relationship with the son, and then figuring out that, oh, this is kind of not really an accident, trying to figure out how to do certain things to prevent people from dying. So it's a really enjoyable movie, so I am going to go ahead and go under enjoyable. Again, it knows the type of movie it is. If you're not really into these type of movies, you probably won't enjoy it. Up next would be Coming to America. I do have a review for this. Oh, like always, anything that I do review within the month will be in the description box down below if you want more fuller thoughts. So again, this is the sequel to Coming to America. A very beloved sequel by many. Personally for me, it's not really a beloved one. I saw it a handful of times and then I rewatched it a couple weeks before this one came out, just to kind of refresh my mind. I was like, when did he impregnate this other female? And of course, in the original, that never came out, but in the sequel, we do have this like stupid ass story of how it happened. So with that, I'm just gonna go ahead and put You Tried because it's really not a good movie. I think I may have given it a medium popcorn, but as I've lingered longer into it, and been able to process more things. It's not really a good movie. You can find this on Amazon Prime if you are interested in the movie, but I feel like it is a pass, to be honest with you. Up next is Netflix's Moxie, who is directed by Amy Poehler. She does star in the movie as well. Well, she's like a side character. She's the mom of the main character. I believe it's based off of a book. I've never read the book myself, but it is a really like female empowerment, stick it to the man kind of deal. Just these teenage girls just sick of the sexism, the double standards. It's a really good concept. I just don't think it was John Wright. If that makes sense. Like, it was a pretty decent movie. We're gonna go ahead and say it's an okay movie. It's an okay. This could have made it up higher. Like, again, it just wasn't executed correctly. I don't know if it's because Amy Poehler was directing it. Maybe if we had got like a different director, I think better director could have made it to that higher level. I just overall don't feel like it was done right. And, you know, we're gonna move on. To another Netflix movie, Yesterday, does star Jennifer Garner, Edgar Ramirez, Jenna Ortega. So basically, it's about these two parents who, before they became parents, were nothing but saying yes. That's kind of where their relationship was. It was yes, 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 we're gonna do this, 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 and that. Of course, once they got married, well, not once they got married, once children came into the factor, it was all no, 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 no. This movie was cute enough, I'm not gonna lie, but would I rewatch it? No. Would I really recommend it for you guys? No, either. I feel like for the family, it's a cute movie. So I'm gonna go ahead and put it under four kids slash family movie, I guess would be the best thing there. Up next would be Raya and the Last Dragon, which is available on Disney Plus in the premium section for 30 extra bucks, or you can watch it in theaters, which is what I did because I was gonna pay $30 to watch the movie. Raya is actually the first Southeast Asian princess. I love her independence. I love how non-fragile she is. I love how she's non-dependent on a man. I love how she's not trying to be saved by a man. I think it is a very good movie. It has beautiful animation and I just overall just love the journey. We're moving on to Nobody, which is a theatrical release. It is like a ripoff of John Wick. It knows what type of movie that it is, but again, like I said in my review, we have like a little dash of The Hunt in there, a little sprinkle of Death Sentence as well, and we have this really nice action-packed movie that I didn't expect to enjoy as much as I did. Like, I saw the trailer, it looked like a lot of fun, but I was just like, I don't know, I'm gonna put it under wow. Because I love action movies like that. So I think it's a really good movie. We're going to move on to Zack Snyder's Justice League. His 4-hour movie that a lot of people say is a huge masterpiece. It's a great improvement from the 2017 Joss Whedon's version that we did get. Like I said in my review for this movie, I personally didn't have a problem with 2017's Justice League version. I mean, now that I saw this one, I mean, I see stuff, you know, obviously that's wrong with that. We do get Martian the Manhunter, Maneater, whatever the hell his name is. I was excited in my review. I am excited about that particular deal because I knew who he was, because I mean, I know I just said I don't watch, you know, the cartoons or anything, but actually prior to watching that, like the same day, like earlier in the day, I did see two animated series. I saw two animated movies. One was more like the Justice League. No, not the Justice League. Was more like Suicide Squad deal. But the first one that I did see, did incorporate this Martian guy. So when I saw him, I went, I know who you are now. Because if I hadn't had seen it, I would have had no freaking idea who he was. But yeah, I do definitely feel like he shouldn't even have been part of the universe, well, part of the movie generally in the first place. And I love what they did with the Flash in this version, like way, way, way better. Whole Aquaman deal, like, there's just too much, like when he's going into the water and we have like the village people, like the women, like singing, like why was that, like it's already long and it's like we have unnecessary singing from like his fans. We have a lot, that's like my major issue, is all the freaking slow motion that we got. Cause like if we had got rid of the slow motion, honestly, from the 4 hours, we're probably gonna chopped it down to about 3.5 hours, which would have still been a great movie without the slow motion. Because honestly, the only character that I feel needed a slow motion would be the Flash. But everybody else did not need all this dramatic slow motion-ness that we got from them. I'm really just trying to give a couple extra things that I didn't give in my official review, because I was trying to get keep that spoiler free. But like again, we're doing spoiler talk right now. That's been on for a minute. Actually, you know what? That's all I'm gonna say about it. Yeah, if you want more detail, like in detail stuff about this movie, like breakdowns and everything, I would refer you to Elliot with Movie Files, because he has like special guests and they like dissect each chapter. They go into detail. They have like a full panel. It's great. Definitely recommend it. I will link his stuff down below if you are wanting more, like people that know what the fuck they're talking about this whole universe. Check him out, he's great. I haven't even put it on a tier list over here, so it was good. It was a good movie. Also, wait, hold on, before I do go forward, what the hell does Steppenwolf do? Like, I'm curious, like, I don't know if I just missed it, or they never really said it, or that's something that comes from like the comic book, the animation. What did he do for him to owe 50,000 worlds or 500,000 worlds, whatever meaning world it is that he owes these people his face when they told him that? Y'all can let me know in the comment section down below. That would be awesome. But moving on to the last movie of the month, which is the one that I just saw yesterday, which actually, I don't know, by the time, I don't know when this video is coming, out today or on Monday. Either way it goes, I just saw this movie the other day. Finally, I'm like super late to the game. Godzilla vs. Kong. It is a great monster movie. Honestly, from all of the monster movies that we've got from this universe, this is definitely my favorite. I think it has like really great CGI in it. I love the fight scenes, which is what we're here to watch, right? Our dumb fighting were great. We basically got 3 rounds. Could have had a little bit more, would have loved. I am Team Kong. You know what? Fuck it. I already said spoilers. Okay, so obviously, technically, Godzilla does beat the shit out of Kong twice. But Kong does end up saving Godzilla there at the end, saving everybody from Mega Godzilla, because Mega Godzilla is in this particular movie. I love the relationship between Kong and Gia. It was super cute. It was a really good movie. Very close to WoW. You can definitely check this out on HBO Max. Zack Snyder's Justice League is also on HBO Max. I don't think I said that. But Godzilla vs. Kong, theaters, HBO Max. If you're able to watch it in theaters, totally, totally recommend it. If not, you can catch it on HBO Max for the next 30 days. Alright guys, so these are the movies that I saw in the month of March, including The Father, which is technically not a March movie, but it is what it is. Let me know down below, what did you guys watch? How do you guys rank it? Do we watch any of the same movies? Don't come after me on where I have Zack Snyder's Justice League. This is just, you know, getting my own personal list. Or Godzilla. It's just my own personal list. You guys may actually have enjoyed those way, way more than I did. But I did enjoy them, you guys. At least I didn't have them further down below. Before I do let you guys go, of course, don't forget to give this video a like. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet. Don't forget to hit the notification bell so you'll be notified each time that I post something new. Till next time, I'll see you guys at concessions. Bye.